and then actually nice for Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday next week.
Yeah, and enjoy it, because apparently Snownado 2 is coming at us, according to Peter Geiger, editor of the Farmer's Almanac. Now, are we your first interview of the year, or have you already done CNN?
Oh, I've done a whole bunch. I'm sorry. But you're the first in Augusta.
No. Great. Well, great.
Well, you know.
Fantastic.
It's a start.
You know, that is a start. But this is, where are your favorite interview of the year? You've said that, right?
Are we? Oh, yeah. No question about it. You are the favorite. And,
oh, good.
You know, last year when we did the Halloween gig, we ended up having like 1,975 kids come to my house. 5,000 candy bars.
Oh,
I mean the Reese's peanut butter cups, which is the number one.
Oh, I
1,250 of those.
Can you bring those this year?
Did I? Could
can
I?
You, can you?
Oh, I could.
Yeah okay.
Depends.
Depends. Yeah.
Depends.
I'll be in those next year too.
Yes.
Never mind. Anyway.
But so you know, we're out. We're talking about the Almanac. It just released. We're in all the stores. This is everything Orange Week. If you go to our website,
I know. Yeah, we were talking about that the other day.
So we're pushing everything orange, including the Farmer's Almanac.
Yep.
And we're talking about the weather, and of course, this year we're talking about it being another nasty winter.
Snownado.
Snownado.
Mm.
Say it isn't snow. And
say
in the past, people would high five me when I say it's going to snow because skiing and all that stuff.
Well, of course.
Nobody has high fived me. Everybody is like so hyped up. The last 3 years we had talked about it being really bad.
Yep.
And it all turned out to be really bad.
Yeah.
And I think this last year in particular, because I was actually heating in June days, some days I was turning on heat.
Yeah.
I mean, it really was brutal.
It was brutal.
What was it, late January into early February? It was like days upon days of school cancellation and things like that.
Yeah.
It was pretty rugged.
I mean, we had called for rain on Christmas last year and rain in early January, and that it did. But then once we hit middle of January, it just went on.
It was about
6 weeks of just snow.
And it didn't really start snowing until the end of January. We thought, you know, through January, well, you know, we're going to get off pretty good this year. And then boom. And then you're right. But when I snow,
yes,
that would have been perfect, because it's snow upon snow upon snow. When I had a snowmobile, it would snow, then it would rain, then it would snow.
Yep.
So this was good for skiers, snowmobilers, snowshoers. Mm-hmm. You're right. It was great winter.
Yeah. So anyway, the Almanac is out. We're in stores. Anybody who's leaving the state on Labor Day, the Maine Turnpike Authority gives away a copy at their toll booth. The Moose.
Miles
Moose.
Yeah.
So he'll be giving out to tourists who are leaving the state.
Yeah.
And meanwhile, we're in Tractor Supply and Hanover, Shaw's, and anywhere.
Rennie's.
Well, Rennie's is giving away copies, too. It may be a month or so from now.
Oh, I see. Okay.
We're a tad early this year.
Tad early.
There's ways to get it. Let me also just say, if you go to my website, farmersalmanac.com, I got like 860 or 70,000 Facebook likes.
Oh, good.
And you know, between Pinterest and Instagram and Twitter, I mean, it's really a great network of people, because no matter what you do, people have got opinions, and
they
we don't discuss the word few. However, we discuss more weighty issues. You know?
Okay, what's your definition of few?
Well, actually, I never agree with you, John. But in this particular case, I brought a few candy bars for you just to get you warmed
up.
Two. And your all-time favorite.
Oh, my goodness.
Charleston 3.
Yes.
This is why he's spoiled.
You brought peanut butter cups. Peanut butter cups. I will share these with my friends.
As your the host of the show, you should be sharing them.
There are three.
Yes. That would be my definition. However, and I am a phalam, so it does carry some weight.
Lover of learning.
However, I think that there probably are multiple definitions as there is in life. And
you're right.
I say, let's just get along here. And
everybody get along.
It was getting a little heated in here.
But anyway, so I'm going to be back for the Halloween show.
Yeah.
But I'm going over to the Capitol for a couple meetings, and I just wanted to stop in and say hi to you guys, because you are so much fun, and you're so interesting, and I learned so much in the morning.
Interesting specimens.
Yeah. Yes, you are. Yeah. Yes.
Look at that fungus.
So
interesting.
Yes.
Yep. So let me ask you one thing before you go. You're talking about the free copies being handed out on Labor Day weekend, which is just a couple weeks away.
Yep.
Now, are these going to be the orange ones, or are these going to be the white ones?
The orange. There's two versions of the Almanac. There's the retail copy, which is 200 pages, and then there's the 64-page, I think, promotional copy, where a business like Rennie's or like the Maine Turnpike Authority puts their name on it, and you get it and you keep it. And
okay.
It's still got all the weather, and it's got all the stories, and just, you know, in quantity. So it's a lot of fun, and there's great stories about, you know, one of my favorite stories, because when you go to the supermarket, and this transcends everybody, you know, what foods are ripe? When do you pick them when they're ripe?
Oh, yeah,
when do
I
they
saw
ripen
this.
Afterwards? Foods that are you should refrigerate, and fruits that you shouldn't refrigerate, and you know, nobody really knows what you're supposed to do in those situations.
No, that's true.
Yeah,
you're
so,
right.
And cucumbers. You have a hangover? Eat a cucumber at night. You'll feel better in the morning.
I don't get hangovers.
Oh.
Weird. I'm weird. But I still eat cucumbers. Maybe it's because I eat cucumbers.
Actually, there's lots of good info in the Almanac. We'll talk about it. We'll talk about it in October.
All right.
We'll find a secret password between now and then.
Yeah.
And trust
me,
for the audience, I don't know what it is yet.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Peter Geiger.
Good to see you guys.
Good to see you, buddy.
Good to see you, Renee.
Editor and Philomath, Farmer's Almanac.